Where did you go, Suzette? Sir James Roundup. Hello, everybody, and welcome to this new edition of the program. The House of Representatives election will be held at the headquarters of 139 Egyptian embassies abroad, excluding four countries due to unrest, namely Libya, Syria, Yemen, and the Central African Republic. The election is scheduled abroad on October 17th. The Deputy Prime Minister and the spokesman for the High Election Commission expect a high turnout by Egyptian expatriate voters in the upcoming parliamentary elections due to the facilities provided by the Commission. The Commission has finalised all preparations for the expat vote. A workshop to train diplomats who will oversee the electoral process will be held. The results of Egyptian expatriate voters will not be announced separately, as was common. The whole result of the election will be announced at the end of the electoral process. Egypt Hisham Ramos was chosen as the Middle East and North Africa's best central bank governor during the IMF and World Bank annual meetings held in Peru from the 8th till the 11th of October. The IMF and the World Bank sources Ramos was based on the measures he took to put Egypt on the right economic path. Ramos was praised for devaluating the Egyptian pound on the dollar by 9.5% and issuing certificates of deposit to finance the expansion of the Suez Canal. The one-day family event will include a variety of cultural activities. On Friday 16th of October, the Austrian Cultural Forum will infuse a lot of parks with activities tailored for families. The event called Austrian Eats Egypt will include polka dance courses and painting workshops. The festive atmosphere will include cultural activities such as artistic performances. With this, the listeners will come to the end of tonight's edition of today's roundup. So we meet again. Have all the best from Cairo. Radio Cairo presents Last Egypt, a program compiled and presented every week by Samar Sini. Hello dear friends, and welcome to a new edition of Last Egypt. In this news on the occasion of the 6th of October, we have the honor to meet with Captain Sam Carter, who is a major troop pilot and is working on the Suez Canal right now. He's one of the heroes participated in the Epoch War of October, and in this edition of the program, he tells us of his memories of his bridges and his own bridges during this war, the victory that England is a threat, its honor and dignity. In the future, we will have the interview.
We noted that all the Egyptian soldiers, I was just thinking that from the biggest title until the smallest one, they all had the same curse, the same strong will, the same resistance that they want to win. And it is well known that the Egyptian soldier, as we know, and our faith tells us that he is one of the best soldiers in the world, as we have in our religion, faith, in other words. So would you please tell me some of the characteristics that of the Egyptian soldiers?
You see, our soldiers in the war, they were doing their, using their good health, good training, and the following instruction of your command, accuracy, and using their weapons as well as that's why we were succeeded in our operation.
And our operation at guerrilla war,
there is no chance for mistake. There is no chance for mistake. That's why we were depending on making strong training, strong physical fitness training, strong training for using the weapon, and also using the land to be able to succeed in our operation. And the soldiers were doing their best to do their job and their mission as well as they have to do. And that's why we were successful. During the time being, our unit in the Navy, the Special Force in the Navy, every year invited us in Ramadan to have iftar. Really, when I visit my unit, I found the same soil, the same our soil, still there, even change, even change. The soldier and officer there, he has the same our story to do their best for the country of Israel.
And we all have the same kind of dignity. I was just saying that the Egyptian people have this kind of honor look up to their army. They all.
And I'll tell you something. Admiral President Sisi, before being president, he was highest staff of the Egyptian army. He visited our unit in the Navy Special Forces. And he made some tests for them, physical fitness tests. And he has seen really a good demonstration there. And he said in his meeting that I need all the Egyptian army to be like this unit.
Wow. He must be very honored. Of course. So,
I'm very proud that I'm working in the personnel, and every day we are making goals for Egypt. We are maybe the main income for Egypt, for the economy of Egypt. And I am very proud that I'm working. And also now I am working in the biggest ship in the world, which is passing the Suez Canal. The Suez Canal now accepts the biggest container, the biggest tanker. I was the pilot of the biggest tanker in the world, called Jara Titan, which passed the Suez Canal. Gross tonnage is 564,000 tons, long 470 meters, wide about 70 meters, high is about 55 meters. This is the biggest ship in the world. Already passed the canal, and I was the pilot. Now, the biggest container in the world, A.P. Muller, Kenny A.P. Muller, is carrying 18,500 containers, already passing the Suez Canal. And there are something like 11 ships in the world, same size, same of them, passing every day in the Suez Canal. Yesterday I was one of those in the canal, passing the Suez Canal. So I am really proud to be pilot in the Suez Canal. And now we are training new pilots to replace us, because now our age coming to 17, so they are going to place us to be the new generation of pilots in the future.
They will be
the first development for our economy and our life in Egypt, and we have a lot of projects in the west and in the north and in the south. We are irrigating land and increasing the area of cultivation in the western area. We are trying to make also nuclear power in Daba, cooperating with Russia. Also, we are making upgrading the New Suez Canal by making factories and resorts for tourists, and also making new properties and new cities in the east of the Suez Canal, New Ismailia, New Cairo. A lot of projects happening. At the same time, we are fighting the trials of tourists, which controlled by power, don't like us to live in peace.
Hopefully they will never.
And we will succeed.
Sir, my last question is concerning a song you used to hear by the time of the war, a patriotic song about Egypt that moved your feelings back then and made you gave you a push, and so I can play it for you by the end of the tour.
This is a song for Said Darwish. يا مصري مصري دايما اسمي دي.
I also love it very much. I'm really
exactly.
Yes,
exactly.
Yes. Thank you so much, sir. I'm really honored. I'm really honored. Thank you.
يا مصري مصري دايما اسمي دي. بنصري نصري دين وارد عليك. يوم ما تعبي رفضك وسمعك. عشت نفسي اللي ضيعت البيت. جنودك في أمورهم للنهار من جنودك كل عظمك استدعى من أثارك يلي بنت الأثار كل بطولك نفسه وانت مستعار
Listeners, we come to the end of tonight's edition of Lost Egypt. Many thanks for our song Infamous for tonight, Hassan Mabrouk, and this is from us, and we wish you a pleasant evening and a great dinner. Welcome back to a show that Charles Charles showed an incomplete fundraiser to Chicago. Prime Minister Senator Cruz today headed to New York on a several-day visit to participate in the session of the UN General Assembly due to be held on October the 15th. Israeli police today reported three separate stabbings across Jerusalem as Palestinian unrest showed looking sign of ending after nearly 2 weeks of violence. Russian jets intensified their airstrikes today in central Syria as government forces battle insurgents in a strategic area near a rebel-held province and the government's stronghold. European Union urged Russia today to halt its aerial bombing campaign in Syria, but will block 28 member states still to agree among themselves on whether Syrian President Bashar al-Assad should have any role in ending the process. Yemen's premier was in Riyadh today to meet President Abdel Mansour Hadi and the Saudi-led coalition backing their administration. Libya's rival parliament and government have rejected the UN proposed peace deal, installing a national unity government, with one lawmaker saying today it would deepen rifts in the North African nation. A doctor and a stand worthy party PKK commander was stated today saying the groups would stick to a unilateral ceasefire announced at the weekend despite Turkish airstrikes against its positions in southeast Turkey and northern Iraq. Fighting said in eastern Afghanistan today, Taliban insurgents threatened to storm another provincial capital 2 weeks after the lightning capture of northern Kunduz city, which marked the biggest military victory of all 3 years. German Chancellor Angela Merkel's Conservatives and her Bavarian allies have agreed on a plan to set up transit zones at the border to force around migrants who clearly have no chance of gaining asylum. The European Commission today ordered Spain to submit a new draft budget with lower deficit estimates to avoid violating the bloc's tough spending rules in a blow to the government ahead of the Spanish elections. Belarus's election fell short of democratic standards, ministers today said after President Alexander Lukashenko won a fifth term, but Europe still looks set to ease tensions with France and Germany, welcomed a lack of political aggression. And finally, Polish Prime Minister Ewa Szczepaczek today announced rather urgent maritime liquefied natural gas LNG terminal on the Baltic coast to ensure that EU members' energy independence from Russia. So this is the case to the end of our news and break from the UN Russian Treasury and the Pirate. Thank you.
The program prepared by Abdul Hakim Siragiri, presented by Mustafa Akhmed. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening, and welcome to a new edition of the program, Tourism Music. Tourism in Brief takes you on a tour to know the latest news of tourism sector in Egypt, in addition to visiting Egyptian land. Tourism Minister conferred with Egypt's ambassador to Spain on the possibility of the ministry's participation in the 7th Cleopatra exhibition to be held in Madrid from November the 30th, 2015 to May the 8th, 2016. The current stage is very important and efforts should be exerted to restore the rate of tourism inflow into Egypt, he said. On the other hand, Egypt's ambassador highlighted the importance of the exhibition as a chance to lure more tourists for Egyptian antiquities. The exhibition is held under an initiative from the cultural authority HML Isabel II, which is considered one of the most important bodies concerned with culture and art in Egypt. Many of the students in Egypt from the school level are the different of the beautiful Western River. This depth is 3,134 meters below sea level. This is the largest 7-6 depression in India. Unlike other depressions, the region of Sahara, the Mulera Oasis, is uninhabited. Bedouin tribes and the large folks do, however, move through the area, utilizing the waters and grass of Mulera for grazing. As you travel through the Sahara Depression, you will see beautiful rock formations that differ in size and shape, as well as saline marshes. Sectionally, you visit the Black Dunes, an group of pools in the southwest of Sahara. These dunes are black due to a fine shale content. Sahara is the last known location where cheetahs can be found in Egypt. Although there are not enough individuals to sustain a population, the Durkas desert is also found here. military operators operating in the Western Desert and from Cairo will have expeditions into the area. Try to stay alive or so, as the area is intensely serene in the evening. Cleopatra's beach is a wonderful bay located on the opposite side of the biggest lagoon in Matsya Matruh. Its clear water is surrounded by rocks with the impression of a vast, square pool in which, according to the legend, Cleopatra came to bath with her lover Mark Antony. Ruins of one of her palaces were uncovered on the hillside opposite the pool, and it seems that a subterranean passage leads from the villa to the beach, perhaps allowing cozy midnight view. It is somewhat challenging to swim between the rocks, with strong currents and waves swirling you around, but after all, maybe that's what you are looking for. Tourism in Greece is a program for that by Abdel Hakim Siragidi, presented by Mustafa Mahmoud. And great thanks to our sound engineer, Ayman Sawara.
Cairo presents The Environment. A program compiled by Mina Ahmed Ishtandubi and is presented by Hidan Mitsu. Dear listeners, and welcome to an edition of The Environment, a news from the USA concerning the health of our planet. The U.S. serves the death of 30 whales along southern Alaska coast. So let's get to the report. In U.S. federal officials said last month, the first marine biologists have noticed an investigation into the mass die-off of 30 whales found north of shore along Alaska's southern coast this summer, nearly three times the region's average for this time of year. Since May 2015, the carcasses of 11 females, 14 humpback whales, one gray whale, and four other whales of indeterminate species turned up along the western Gulf of Alaska, according to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. They declare the cluster of whale deaths an unusual mortality event, triggering a formal agency inquiry into the standing that would bring together federal and local experts, especially from this team. The National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration Marine Mammal Health and Standing Response Coordinator said that while they do not yet know the cause of these findings, their investigations would give them important information on the health of whales and the ecosystems where they live. National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration fisheries spokeswoman said that a leading typhoon thesis for the cause of the death is that they may be linked to a toxic algae bloom in the Pacific Ocean along the U.S. West Coast that has led to the closure of shellfish harvests in Washington State, Oregon, and California. She said that the bloom, which first appeared in May, involved a microscopic algae that produced and your adoption potentially safer to human souls than more acid. But if you will, from this so far this summer, will secure a longer span of coastline stretching more than 1,000 miles, that 20,600 kilometers from south of the Anchorage to the Aleutian Islands. National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration said that to date, the trending salaries amount to over 3 times the historical average for such well depth in the region. According to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration shipping spokeswoman, the most recent blow catches in the group was found in mid-August. She said that the formal investigation, which began in September, could take months, even years, of data collection and analysis. Dear listeners, time for today's edition of Environment is over. However, we look forward to meeting you soon. Until then, I have all the best wishes from the compiler Mina Akhnavishman Dubit, our sound engineer Muhammad Anwar, and this is myself, Shiva Nasim, wishing you all the best from the virtual practice.
Radio Cairo presents From Our Heritage. Dear listeners, welcome to a new edition of the program From Our Heritage, in which you'll be introduced to different customs and traditions through time from the Quranic era up to now. Hope you enjoy it. Immediate the family is the center of a person's entire life, is unlike the case in most modern Western cultures. The young people are encouraged to direct their energies towards the society and toward their independence. Immediate most young people, male and female, live in the same house with a parent, at least until they get married. Usually heavy requirements of marriage, and though some get married quite young, others may not get married until they are at their 30s or 40s. A new apartment must be provided for the bride in order for the marriage to take place. This is officially the bride's duty, rather the groom's duty, while the furnishing and decorations are both the bride's and the groom's responsibility. The fact is that in the different tradition, the family is the strongest force in people's lives until the day they die. Children learn to respect the parents and other adults from the youngest age. Girls learn to help their mothers until whatever will be self-worth and take responsibility for the younger siblings. The Western change is rebelling against the parents' values, moving away from one's family to strive out on one's own, have never found a way into Egyptian society. Families often eat together and may spend Fridays with their family. The whole extended family usually gets together for meals, a feast or other occasions. Egyptian extended families, grandparents, aunts, uncles and cousins all feel united by planned ties and responsibilities to care for each other closely. Well, dear listeners, that's all for today. I'm going to move on with an interesting Egyptian tradition. Goodbye. Come on.
Radio Cairo presents Wonders of Creation. Prepared and compiled by Nashat Al-Masri. And brought to you by Wonder Beauty. Hello everyone and welcome to a new edition of the program. Love is a magic window upon the pleasures of life. With little mediation, one discovers that one is gifted with two permanent windows upon everything we love. These are our beloved friends, that is, our eyes. In times of distress, we may move to a place or a scene we love to get rid of our worries or troubles. We enjoy beautiful scenes that make life enjoyable or desirable. In the meantime, our eyes distance us from sources of danger, and thus we can consider them our sincere and loyal friends. The eye is definitely the finest and most delicate organ of the human body. However, it can undertake continual difficult tasks, and it performs them most surprisingly accurately without taking any direct commands. Our eyes are our way to gaining knowledge. Most of the information we get is first received by the memory and the steering nerve center by way of the eye. The brain that trusts the correctness of the information sent by the eye makes the necessary analysis and reaches the right conclusion. This means that the eye is the organ that offers the material, the tools, and preliminary items for thinking and taking decisions. Eyes are ball shaped as we know, and their diameter is about 2.2 centimeters. They do not grow much, as is in the body's growth, and this is the reason why children's eyes look too big compared to the size of their faces. This is an additional advantage and a source of beauty when one imagines that eyes could grow 7 times their size throughout the stages of childhood, youth, and adulthood. If this happens, regardless of eye color or brightness, they would like and look really frightful, or at least very discomforting.
Tears discharged by the eyes play an important role in its health and protection against germs, in addition to easing their movements. They discharge 2 years of each 1 cubic centimeter every day, except in cases of sadness or acute pain. In addition to the benefits of tears, they are an outlet for psychological pressure. The eye's spontaneous movement and its ability to distinguish between 10 million degrees of color shades supersedes the function of any man-made camera. The pictures that it takes that reach the brain through the optical nerve is less than 1/10 of a second. The eye moves from one scene to another in less than 1/64 of a second, and its eyelashes and eyelids can make very tiny movements in a matter of minutes. It is a great wonder and a mercy of God that the eye does not pick any light rays under or above its power that could become a great burden to one's movements in life. Imagine the movement of a bee whose eyes can take the ultraviolet rays, and this explains what we say. Thanks be to the great Creator who lets us to enjoy everything in life without much trouble or effort in man and in our life circumstances and in our body function. That was the wonder of creation for today. Our friends, beloved friends, our eyes. Until a new wonder, so stay and be well. This is as we come to the end of our transmission for tonight from Ray to Tara. But before reading you, would like to remind you that Tara beams to Europe and the freight is on meter back 9870 kHz. And we start from 23 to 24:45 local time. That is 21:15 to 22:45 GMT. So to meet again, have all the best from all of us here. Ladies and gentlemen, have a very good night and bye-bye.